couplers. Looks like your job is just about finished with. May get an inch or so today, and that should just about do it. Temperatures getting into the upper teens at 17 right now, but notice the wind chill, still 14 below, 17 below at Minneapolis, and Minot, the coldest on this map, 21 below. So while the snow is tapering off, it'll stay very chilly here through the northern plains. 13 International Falls, 42 in Rapid City. So we do have a warm up. The warmer temperature is starting to rise up through the plains, so getting better gradually. As a matter of fact, our snowstorm is now changing over to a rainstorm. The snows will be real light from around Green Bay back to Kansas City, some accumulations, but for the most part, we're looking at heavy rain today. And that is from Ohio to the eastern seaboard, down through Florida. And it does look like this is going to stick around for the remainder of the weekend, with our storm system real slowly lifting northeastward and kind of changing positions a little bit. We'll start to draw in that moisture from the Atlantic. So heavy rains, which means 2 or possibly 3 inches, maybe some flooding. And with the onshore winds around this area of high pressure, we may have coastal flooding before the rain ever gets here. At the time of high tide, could be some problems from Wachill to Manasquin Inlet, from Cape Henelope down to Virginia Beach. And again, it's the onshore wind, not really the rain, that will cause the flooding problems, or could cause the flooding problems through here. Let's get a look at a couple of radars. We'll start you here in the northeast and show you where the rains are. Not into New York City as of yet. Philadelphia still dry, but wet weather coming in this evening and lasting through much of your Sunday. The heaviest for the travel day tomorrow is probably going to be in New England. At the moment, it's Syracuse to Rochester. By the way, it's all rain. Warm enough to keep it rain, it looks like, down towards Du Bois. Now, once you get back into Ohio, here's where the colder air is just coming in. So perhaps a quick change over to snow before the precipitation comes to an end. Any amounts that accumulate here in the form of snow should be real light. For the most part, this is rain. And it extends on farther to the south through Virginia, with some heavier rain and some thunderstorms starting to develop. And the rain goes on down through the Carolinas. It's much lighter today in Georgia and in Florida. A few scattered showers, but that should just about do it. As we back out, you can see the back edge of the clouds is here around Dayton. Looks like Nashville in the clear, and Birmingham about to clear out. And then the cloud cover here is right under that area of low pressure. And again, windy, cloudy, still real cold here, and a little bit of light snow. If you continue working your way westward, you'll run into our next storm system about to come ashore. Already the clouds coming in here, a little bit of moisture into the Pacific Northwest, where there's still a lot of cold air, especially trapped in the valley. So what we're getting is freezing rain, another ice problem here, especially east of the Cascades, Washington, a little bit into Oregon. More of the same for at least another 24 hours. Again, things are just starting to happen here, so we'll be talking more about that. We may get a little bit of rain down into California, but Southern California looks like it's going to be in pretty good shape. Let's check it out with our forecast. Light precipitation into the northwest, light snow here, heavy rain with our storm system in the east that will be lifting northeastward. So New England down through Philadelphia and DC, rain Sunday morning as you hit the roadways through the afternoon. It probably will be an improving looking forecast for Philadelphia and DC, down to the south, clearing out. A little sunshine in Atlanta, should be a pretty nice day. New England doesn't look so great. Probably some delays at the airports and a lot of heavy rain to slow you down. At this point, it does look like more rain and more snow coming into the west. So this is our next big storm system that will be crossing the country over the next few days. Snow in the Cascades, still east of the Cascades, the possibility of some freezing rain. West, right along the coastline, mainly rain, and that would be down towards San Francisco, maybe a little farther south than that, but probably not to Santa Barbara and LA. We'll just stick with some clouds through there. Heartland of the country, nice and dry, but on the edges, some wet weather. Heaviest here, possibly 2 or 3 inches. The snow now has really tapered off, so we're looking for maybe an inch or two, and that's probably about it. Mainly flurries through here, and still some blowing snow, so that will continue to be a problem. Temperatures will remain very cold during the nighttime hours, but looking a whole lot better by day as we see the 50s and 60s coming northward. The 20s, that's the sort of the center of our storm system here, and the cold air kind of works its way across the Great Lakes and then lifts off to the north and east. So a warming trend for the first part of next week in the east. Now as that new system comes into the west, temperatures will drop back again after a few days in the 40s and 30s. The 20s kind of re-enter the picture, but it won't get nearly as cold as it did ahead with the last system, so some good news out there. Snow continues in the northeast. As a matter of fact, lake effect snows come in on Monday behind the rain, but as that dries out in the east, the next storm system here works its way into the Rockies. Mainly light snow. We're starting to pick up some moisture from the Gulf come Tuesday, and the whole thing kind of comes together on Wednesday. So some rains, some mixed precipitation, and some snow that will continue on through Thursday.
What's up, Helen?
Okay.
I guess I've had this whole Stanley about 6 years now. Boys, been through it. Been dropped, run over, beat up. You name it, it's been through it. There's not another thermos anywhere that can take it like this one. See what I mean?
The Aladdin Stanley All-Steel Thermos, guaranteed for life.
This holiday, give the gift that lasts a lifetime, a Stanley Steel Thermos bottle by Aladdin.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Channel programming is brought to your home through a partnership with your local cable company. When you pay your cable bill each month, you help support our programming. Thank you.
Skiers in the east may not like the forecast a whole lot, as we see all the cloud cover here. Unfortunately, underneath these clouds, it's rain and not snow, and we're going to see probably a whole lot more rain through the remainder of the weekend, followed by a little bit of snow. It's light snow still back across the western Great Lakes, and we may pick up at least some lake effect snows come Monday, and it'll start to taper off on Tuesday. In the meantime, most of the ski resorts are open and doing okay. With the cold nights we've had recently, they've been making snow like crazy. Sunday River, Maine, 40-inch base, same as true at Killington. They have 22 trails open. Loon Mountain, New Hampshire, 3 trails open. And Waterville Valley has a 2-foot base, as does Mount Snow and Haystack in Vermont. Stand the chance of getting some snow in the near future, so hang in there, but of course the rain first. And the same is true in Snowshoe, West Virginia, where they are probably getting some rain right now. Light snow expected where you see the pink on the map, and when we're talking light, we mean 1 or 2 inches. That's probably about it. They did pretty well through the western Great Lakes. They picked up some decent snow, so most of the resorts that opened this week probably looking pretty good out there. The Northeast been making snow, rain today and tomorrow, and then come Monday as we pick up the northwest winds, that should bring some lake effect snows into the picture. Hunter Mountain probably will get some snow. Camelback may get some snow, and up towards Killington and Mount Snow, probably a little bit out there at least. That may be a few inches, not a whole lot. Again, a little bit more on Tuesday, then that system moves out. We'll have some decent weather before the next storm system comes in a little bit later in down the road. So we'll be telling you more about that and the cold weather that may now be on the way out. More to come.
You know, winning a Super Bowl was great, but now I'm winning with Interstate Batteries.
We won the ultimate NASCAR race.
We won the Daytona 500.
Get an Interstate battery wherever you see this sign. We check them before you buy them. For fresh power, guaranteed.
This Christmas, give something that will make them ho, ho, ho all year long. Hey! Give the new shower a massage. Vitaldyne and water.
Gesundheit. A friendly reminder. You can call 1-800-WALGREENS any time of day or night to find the nearest 24-hour location of the pharmacy that offers more 24-hour locations than anyone else. 1-800-WALGREENS. The number to call when you already know the time and temperature.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Olympus cameras at a retail store near you or call 1-800-O-CAMERA.
The holiday countdown is sponsored by Olympus. Never miss another O. Well, you have 28 shopping days left till the big day. And if you're heading out this afternoon, the malls should still be crowded. Lots of sales on, so the folks will be out there in droves, and you're going to be fighting the weather from Buffalo to Columbus, Ohio, down to Atlanta, maybe a few more sprinkles around, but the heaviest rain is probably to your northeast now. Fortunately, we don't have a whole lot more snow in the forecast, so it's pretty light from Green Bay back to Kansas City and actually dry now across the Rockies and warming up. More snow and rain perhaps on the way, though, as the next system comes ashore tomorrow. It's actually already messy here through Washington and Oregon. Freezing rain and some snow, more of the same on Sunday. Should move out thereafter. So we're definitely seeing this system move out and the next one already on the way in. So we'll continue to see some problems. Temperatures on Sunday, not too terrible until you get to the 20s here in the western Great Lakes. And your probability of a white Christmas, a little early to tell, but by standards over the past few years, historically, these are the areas most likely to see a white Christmas. Stick around for your local forecast next.
Sun, snow, rain, or fog. Know what to expect. Just 95 cents a minute. Dial 1-900-WEATHER and connect.
Flex Power Pro outperforms Solaflex and Nordic Flex, and we can show you how. Call this toll-free number now, and we'll send our head-to-head comparison video absolutely free. You'll see why the Bowflex cable pulley system can give you better results than Solaflex or Nordic Flex. You'll see how your workouts with Bowflex can be 27% faster than Nordic Flex and 46% faster than Solaflex. Bowflex is more versatile. It comes with a lifetime warranty, and it's simply a better value for you. Sound interesting? Call now, and you'll also receive this fact-filled brochure that details the quality, performance, and convenience that only Bowflex can deliver. Go ahead, call and make your own comparison. The time and money you save will be worth it.
If you're about to travel, watch the 5-Day Business Planner here on the Weather Channel at 20 minutes after every hour. You get a comprehensive national report that covers the forecast over the next 5 days. Watch the 5-Day Business Planner coming up soon on the Weather Channel. Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
The Weather and Your Health is sponsored by TavisD, 12-hour relief without a prescription. It's already time to start talking about the influenza report, and this was updated as of November 18th, at which time those states shaded in yellow, including Vermont and Ohio, Texas, California, all were reporting sporadic cases of the flu. Before you know it, we'll have orange and red on the map indicating regional or widespread cases of the flu, because it always gets worse before it gets better, and flu season generally ends in March. So we'll continue to update you through the next few months. Respiratory distress usually comes into play when you have wet weather, windy or cold weather, and we certainly have that along the eastern seaboard today and tomorrow, and in the northwest with a new storm system coming ashore. So those are the areas that if you have a chest cold or you have asthma, you may be feeling it through the next 24 hours. Pain index goes up generally with pressure changes or changes in the humidity. Storm systems coming through, so just about the same areas you could be feeling it if you are prone to that kind of thing, if you have arthritis or something like that. No problems with air stagnation, so there's your good news. We'll check the radars. We'll show you where that heavy rain is coming up next.
You can't breathe. You're sneezing. Your sinuses and nasal passages are blocked. Where do you go for help? Last time you went to your doctor for a prescription. This time he told you to get the same prescription strength medicine without a prescription. Tavis D, the antihistamine decongestant that was once the most prescribed by doctors, is now the most recommended by doctors for 12 hours of relief.
Good morning.
Tavis D, one tablet, 12 hours, no prescription.
Look for Tavis at your local pharmacy.
I see you like Pine Cleaner.
Oh, I just love Pine Sol.
Well, that's not Pine Sol Cleaner.
Well, it smells piney, and it's a bargain.
Guess how many bottles of that it would take to equal the cleaning power in one bottle of Pine Sol?
Well, two.
Another.
Three.
Another.
Four.
Another.
Five?
Five.
It takes five of these to equal one bottle of Pine Sol?
And they don't disinfect like Pine Sol either.
Well, it doesn't smell like a bargain anymore. I'll take my Pine Sol.
It takes more than pine smell to clean like Pine Sol.
Check on a couple of radars. First thing we want to show you is the national perspective. And most of the rain here will show up in the east, and it is heavy rain, not much snow, just a brief changeover perhaps in central Ohio to snow. A little bit of light snow left here in the plains, but we're definitely seeing the changeover now from our big snowstorm becoming a big rainstorm. And then as we check the west coast, a little bit of green showing up on the map here. Light rain along the coast, snow in the mountains, and freezing rain east of the Cascades that may continue to be a problem tonight and tomorrow. This is the next big storm coming ashore, and we will be telling you more about that with the five-day forecast that's coming up. But right now we want to zoom in here in the east and give you an idea of what's going on. The heaviest rain at this point, probably here through the Carolinas. Some thunder showers have come through Charleston, up towards Fayetteville and Raleigh-Durham. Steady light rain then extending on up to around Charlottesville in Virginia and around Washington, D.C. Still dry, but this stuff is heading northeastward and should come through. Wet weather for D.C. probably the rest of today and much of tomorrow up until maybe late afternoon. Again, cold rain here in Ohio, maybe changing over, mixing with some snow, and the rain's then extending and pushing into Southern New England soon.
Everybody needs some money sometimes. Everybody needs some cash somehow.
Hello?
Rita.
It's midnight.
I need $500. Now.
I'll call Western Union.
Just call 1-800-CALL-CASH and you can send money from home.
My sometime is now.
Western Union.
Oh, yeah.
The fastest way to send money.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Thank you.
now to check the five-day forecast. This will get us back to work or school on Monday, but we'll start off with the current scenario, and it's kind of messy here for the remainder of the weekend in the east. A lot of heavy rain now. Flash flood watches are out anywhere from New York down through the Appalachians, and the rain could amount to 2 or 3 inches tomorrow, shifting into the northeast, but taking a while to really move on out of here. So traveling tomorrow, especially in the northeast, will be real nasty. The rain should be coming to an end gradually from about D.C. down to Atlanta. May have a little bit of leftover snow, but it should be pretty light, and accumulations shouldn't amount to a whole lot. That doesn't mean it won't be slick out there. That's definitely a possibility. Detroit, Cleveland, maybe even over towards Chicago for the next 24 hours. But the heartland's looking very nice now after a nasty holiday. Dallas is in good shape, and Denver's heading up through the 50s. Not bad. We'll just be waiting for this next storm to come ashore. And it looks like by Sunday afternoon, we'll have more of the same in the northwest. They're already seeing freezing rain. The orange on the map indicates more expected. Snow through the Cascades and down through the Shasta and Siskiyou Range, and then rain right along the coastline, perhaps extending as far south as San Francisco, Sacramento, but probably not down to Santa Barbara or L.A. You should stay pretty much in the quiet zone, just a few clouds around. More cold nights, that's no surprise, especially if you have clear skies. It can drop down to the 20s pretty quickly, but a warm-up with sunshine on Sunday takes you to the 60s in Dallas, 50s for Denver. The heart of the cold air is still kind of banked right in here. Minneapolis, Chicago in the 20s, wind chills probably below zero, and it doesn't take a whole lot of wind to take temperatures way down. So even just slightly breezy conditions will make it nasty. The cold air is trying to move on out. Still be kind of chilly on Monday, but Tuesday looks pretty good. So the warm-up begins here in the east, and the west isn't too bad either, right up through about Wednesday. And then we see more cold air coming in with that storm that's now approaching the west coast. As it comes in, we should see temperatures drop back to about 20 for afternoon highs. But even this is not bad compared to what we were dealing with last Wednesday and Thanksgiving Day and even yesterday. Alrighty, the rain in the northeast ends and the snow comes in with the colder air coming across the Great Lakes. Lake effect snow is expected on Monday. That gradually tapers off come Tuesday or Wednesday. Meanwhile, our storm system here exits the west coast, enters the intermountain region with some light snow on Tuesday. Things start to pick up on Wednesday, and this one is moving very slowly again. So more rains and snows southwest.
I can see them with my eyes closed. The landscape of every finger, his lifeline, the scar from when he rescued the neighbor's cat, his hands, they embrace my soul. I will care for them as they have for me. Now, as for the rest of his body...
Isotoner's unique fit surrounds the hand in comfort to protect what you cherish. Don't miss our generous pre-holiday sale now through December 4th. It's our gift to you.
When most manufacturers develop a new truck, they start with a model. Good idea. Here's ours. Introducing the first and only family of trucks designed from the inside out. A design that starts with you and has become the all-new Chevy S-Series. Everything else is history.
Look for private lesson ski tips every day on the Weather Channel, sponsored by Chevy Truck.
Here's a private lesson from Skiing Magazine and the Weather Channel, sponsored by Today Chevrolet.
Hi, I'm Hank Cashwell with a skiing tip for advanced skiers. When you're skiing on steep terrain, it's really important to ski from your waist down and let your legs turn your skis. Well, you'll keep your upper body facing down the hill. If you overturn your upper body, you'll end up with your weight on your uphill ski in an unbalanced position. Try this. Finish a turn by steering your skis across the hill, keeping your upper body facing downhill, your knees flexed, and your skis on edge. This twists or winds up the muscles in the middle of your body and stores energy to start the next turn. To keep your upper body from twisting too, plant your pole down the hill. Now, release the edges by extending your legs forcefully. This will allow your body to unwind, releasing the energy and helping to get the new turn started. Remember, keep the upper body facing downhill on steep terrain. For more skiing tips, read the private lesson section of Skiing Magazine and keep on watching the Weather Channel.
El Nino, not the harmless baby its name suggests, but a monster weather engine so powerful it can affect two-thirds of the surface of the Earth. Now, a new title from the Weather Channel for your video library, El Nino, Drought to Deluge. How is this mysterious weather phenomenon responsible for drought that turned a coastline into a tinderbox? For rainfall so intense that winter becomes the season of flood? Plus, from storm chaser Warren Fadley, severe storms through the camera's eye, from hellacious hailstorms through dust, lightning, and tornadoes, plus new storm chaser highlights and the rules for survival, and this handy guide to weather from behind the wheel. What do you do when you're caught in the car facing a tornado, flood, or other hazardous situation? Call toll-free 1-800-525-7700 now, and you can own El Nino, severe storms, and your driving weather safety guide for just $19.95. Call 1-800-525-7700 now and charge by phone, or send check or money order to the address on the screen. Call now.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel. Is the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to for accurate, dependable weather forecasts 24 hours a day.
Thanks for joining us this afternoon. We've been talking so much about cold weather lately, we thought we'd give you a glimpse at some warm weather. You kind of have to make a little trip of it, but San Juan, Puerto Rico is up to 89 degrees. Most of the lower 48, on the other hand, has been dealing with winter's chill a little early this go around. We've had record lows again this morning, a number of them, including Pocatello, Idaho, San Antonio, Texas, Corpus Christi. But at least in Texas, it's warmed up pretty nicely this afternoon. We are now in the warming trend, so our cold air system is starting starting to drift off to the north and east. The 50s coming back into the picture, and the teens should be moving on out. But a couple more cold days ahead, especially across the Great Lakes, where I'll take you to Minneapolis, it's just 18 degrees at this hour, 14 in International Falls. Factor in the winds, and it's still going to feel like it is well below zero in many locations. Breezy conditions expected all through the northern plains, and then also wind advisories out for surface, and you get the warm, moist air coming up over top of it. It starts as rain, but it gets down to, say, Stampede Pass, and the temperature is about in the mid-teens, so it freezes on contact. That's going to be the worst of the driving conditions probably today. But snow and blowing snow through here, and of course the real heavy rains along the eastern seaboard that will be lifting northeastward. New England, New York, down through Philadelphia, down to Washington, D.C. Heavy rains through Sunday morning. Getting better by afternoon, however, around D.C. and probably Philadelphia. So if you want to hold off on your traveling until then, that might not be a bad idea. We don't expect a real clearing trend, however, in New York or Boston throughout Sunday. And the rains and the snow should pick up on the West Coast around Sunday afternoon as well. Nice weather for much of the center of the country, but some problems still out there. Precipitation amounts will start off pretty light northwest, but then picking up within the next 24 hours as more of that moisture comes in from the Pacific. We could get a tenth to a half inch, 2-3 inches possible here with the heavy and steady rains. The snow, not such a problem anymore, about an inch or 2 inches in a pretty narrow band. And of course, the snow is now picking up in the Cascades and down into the mountains of Northern California as well. We're still going to be dealing with some real cold temperatures during the morning hours with clear skies. Places like Dallas and maybe dropping down into the 20s. Hopefully all of the moisture will have evaporated from the sidewalks and such, so it won't be as big a problem. And we'll be back up into the 60s tomorrow after, I think, mid-50s today. So this is looking pretty good for the folks here. Nicer in Denver, the Rockies again clear now and a little bit warmer. The coldest air still around Minneapolis to Green Bay to Chicago in the 20s on Sunday. A little bit of a breeze and wind chills will be below zero. Eastern seaboard is relatively mild and that cold air working its way across the Great Lakes and into the northeast come Monday. A warming trend, however, so we are getting rid of that real cold air and we're switching back to 40s rather than 20s in Chicago come Tuesday. 50s and 60s expanding, getting a little bit better, but then the next blast of cool air comes in with that Pacific storm system. So 20s are back on the map, widespread by Thursday, but this isn't going to be nearly as cold as the last storm that came through. So some good news for you. Lake effect snows kick in on Monday. Once the rain moves on out, they'll taper off on Tuesday. In comes our storm system with light snow showers, but things start to pick up on Wednesday, especially southwest to Texas. Wednesday and Thursday look pretty messy with snow, a mix, and rain.
You know, winning a Super Bowl is great, but now I'm winning with Interstate Batteries.
And this year, we won the ultimate NASCAR race.
We won the Daytona 500.
Interstate has a lightning-fast restocking system, so we had a fresh, powerful battery for a great start and a winning finish. So get the battery that won the Daytona 500. Wherever you see this sign, Interstate Batteries. We check them before you buy them. For fresh power, guaranteed.
Dressing your kids for school can be downright elementary when you watch the school day forecast weekday mornings 35 minutes after the hour on the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
kind of my throat.
Sore throats hurt. That's why we introduced TriMinix Sore Throat Formula. The new children's medicine made for coughs and colds with sore throats. TriMinix, just tell us where it hurts.
Look for TriMinix at this fine store.
Rub-a-dub-dub, pretend you're a tub with a bad case of soap scum. Wouldn't you like to be cleaned by soft scrub with Clorox bleach? Clean soap scum safely without harsh scratching. Soft scrub with bleach and soft scrub cleanser, preferred by tubs everywhere.
A standard set by the federal government requires that a car with two airbags must help protect two passengers, ignoring the center seat passenger. The higher standard in the all-new DeVille by Cadillac. An airbank system which provides supplemental protection for not one, not two, but all three front seat passengers. The airbank system in the new V8-powered DeVille by Cadillac. Creating a higher standard.
Take you over to Europe next. It's been kind of chilly there. They're starting to warm up, very much like here in the States. As a matter of fact, with a warmer forecast for Sunday, we'll check it out with 18 cities.
Start of another day and the start of that all too familiar morning routine. You know it well, but what you may not know is how the current weather conditions might affect you and your family's day. Make the Weather Channel part of your morning routine. This morning's weather is designed to fit your busy morning schedule with accurate forecasts, including expected temperatures, precipitation, and the threat of severe weather. Depend on it to help you plan your day. This morning's weather on the Weather Channel, weather you can always turn to.
It's late, it's dark, and it's dangerous. And you and someone you love have broken down. What are you going to do to help make yourself visible to oncoming traffic when you're just sitting there, stuck on the side of the road? So be prepared with this. Introducing Lifeman, a breakthrough in electronic design. Lifeman is a rugged, lightweight, and weatherproof ultra-high-intensity strobe that puts out powerful, brilliant flashes of light. And it's visible from every direction, warning others that you're stopped on the side of the road.
It's an emergency light.
I think it's an excellent device for people to keep in their cars when their vehicle is broken down.
Just a simple push of a button and you can place Lifeman anywhere. Order Lifeman today for yourself or for someone whose safety you care about.
It's a great gift idea. I'd give it to anybody who spends time on the road.
Everyone's getting one in their Christmas stocking this year.
Use your credit card to order Lifeman for $19.95 plus shipping and handling by calling 1-800-257-8111 or send a check or money order to the address on your screen.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Priceless 500,000 Steinway piano was moved on a year-long tour of the U.S. by Wheaton Worldwide Moving without a scratch. Wheaton is also the official mover of the NBA, moving the valued possessions of players and personnel across America. Wheaton can move you, too, from sea to shining sea. For our free money-saving brochure, call 1-800-248-4810.
For this and more valuable moving information, talk to one of our over 300 professional Wheaton agents nationwide. See your Yellow Pages for the Wheaton agent nearest you.
I've spent years watching her. Tall, chin up, poised. Always walk like a lady, she'd say, as we glided across the room laughing, our books perfectly balanced. Mom will be fine. She'll get to her hotel, kick off her heels, and find my surprise in her suitcase. She'll call.
Isotoner's extra cushioning surrounds the foot in comfort to protect what you cherish. Don't miss our generous pre-holiday sale now through December 4th. It's our gift to you.
It's been a chilly couple of weeks in Europe, very much like here in the States. We'll check current temperatures. You can see it's just 43 degrees in London. That's not actually that cold. Paris is a little cooler. Their typical high this time of year is mid to upper 40s, and right now it's 30, cooling off because it is evening, but it's definitely been a chilly day again. Moscow, 19 degrees. That's one of the warmer temperatures we've seen in some time. So looks like the cold snap is beginning to break here in Europe. Let's check the satellite picture. We'll show you what's been going on. Had some cloud cover coming in against high pressure, so all of this moisture perhaps will not make it any further in than Scotland and Ireland and maybe over towards Portugal. But we have that little system here spinning around for a couple of days, bringing a little bit of rain into the picture. Looks like that's still on the map. Check of the forecast will show us a little bit of light snow perhaps coming across Poland and up through the Baltic states, and still that unsettled weather in southern Italy, and that's basically it. So pretty quiet forecast, but still a little on the chilly side. A lot of 20s and 30s out there. Moscow should stay in the teens. If you're headed to Athens on Sunday, it'll be partly cloudy with a high near 50. Fog in Brussels and in London. London won't get out of the low 40s, so a little cooler forecast for you. Madrid, partly cloudy, mid 50s. Showers still possible in Rome. And in Paris, fog on Sunday, temperatures only in the mid-30s. Our winter storm update here in the States is next.
Planning a trip to the Orient? The latest Asian forecasts and travel information are just a phone call away. 1-900-WEATHER for 95 cents a minute. Next. Weather information you need whenever you need it. Direct to you by telephone. Call your source of weather information, the Weather Channel Connection.
Flex Power Pro outperforms Solaflex and Nordic Flex, and we can show you how. Call this toll-free number now, and we'll send our head-to-head comparison video absolutely free. You'll see why the Bowflex cable pulley system can give you better results than Solaflex or Nordic Flex. You'll see how your workouts with Bowflex can be 27% faster than Nordic Flex and 46% faster than Solaflex. Bowflex is more versatile. It comes with a lifetime warranty, and it's simply a better value for you. Sound interesting? Call now, and you'll also receive this fact-filled brochure that details the quality, performance, and convenience that only Bowflex can deliver. Go ahead. Call and make your own comparison. The time and money you save will be worth it.
You're watching the Weather Channel. Accurate and dependable forecast you can always turn to. And when you're away from your television, the Weather Channel forecast is also available from the following.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Holiday message will go right over most people's heads. It's the holiday sweater sale at JCPenney. Save 20 to 30% on hand knit crew necks, cable V-necks, and textured roll necks, all at 20 to 30% off. So drop by our place during the holiday sweater sale. With so many locations, there's bound to be one in your neck of the woods.
Bifocals. I'm gonna look just like my father. My grandfather. Wait, nobody will notice the lines if I do some cool frames. Or something. This is not working.
For those who refuse to be seen in bifocals, we offer the perfect disguise. Verilux No-Line Bifocals. The vision you need, the look you want, none of the lines. Call for a Verilux professional near you.
Consult your eye care professional. Call 1-800-VARILUX for the practitioner nearest you.
And now an update on our winter storm that's kind of gripped the nation for the past few days. I think it's losing its grip now. We can see a warm-up in temperatures, a lot more 50s here across the plains. That's not bad. Denver at 51 after several days down there in the single digits and wind chills well below zero. Can't complain about this. The heart of the cold air now around Minneapolis, just 18 there. Kind of cold in Chicago, 32, and Des Moines is just 24 degrees. But it's still looking a whole lot better than it was just a couple days ago. Thanksgiving Day, we had record lows in all of these cities with the blue dots. There were more than on Friday morning and even more today. So we can't seem to lose the real cold mornings. As cold as 12 below in Pocatello, Idaho. Waco, Texas was 22. Much of Texas had record lows, but a nice warm-up this afternoon. Everybody back in the 50s and the ice melting away out of Dallas. But now that the really cold weather is on the way out and the snow, we're picking up the heavy rains. Yesterday was especially heavy in and around Atlanta, also Columbus, Georgia, and Macon, with several locations seeing 1.5 to 2.5 inches of rain. A little bit lighter and more scattered in Georgia today, and we're picking up the rains a little farther to the north. So anywhere really from Alabama to Tennessee and North Carolina, and now extending all the way up to New York State. Heavy rains, 1 to 3 inches possible through here. Maybe a brief changeover in central Ohio to snow before it comes to an end. But this is now really a rainstorm. And even before the rain gets to the northeast coastline, we may see flooding. Reason being, we've had a real strong onshore wind. So at the time of high tide, there's a possibility of coastal flooding. And the area shaded in green are most likely to see that. So it could be a little rough for another 24 hours. And the rains are likely to continue through Sunday. So as you make your travel plans to head out today or tomorrow, expect it to be very soggy and maybe even some minor flooding problems. Flood watches are out for those areas shaded in dark green. And you notice a little bit of green on the map here in the northwest. That's the next storm coming ashore. And we'll tell you more about that with our good afternoon forecast. Let's check it out. Our first storm, the one that's been here since last Sunday, still hanging on, but lifting northeastward. So the rains, the heavy stuff coming into New England by Sunday morning, and the snow should be pretty light. So that does not look like it will be a big travel problem. Getting a little bit drier from D.C. to Atlanta. Sunday doesn't look too bad, but at this time now the moisture really streaming into the west, which could mean rain for San Francisco and Sacramento, then some snow up through the Northern California mountains, east of the Cascades with the cold air trapped at the surface and that warm, moist air coming in over top of it. Rain coming through that cold air will freeze on contact. So that may be the worst of the driving for Sunday. Up to 3 inches possible here. That's why we had flash flood watches out. But the snow is likely to be very light. 1 or 2 inches probably should just about do it. More cold readings on Sunday morning, but it does look a little warmer for Sunday afternoon and should be warmer yet on Monday. We'll get to that forecast coming up shortly.
What do dogs respond to? The taste of meat. Iams knows meat protein makes dogs look and feel healthy. It's so important for eyes, muscle tone, skin and coat, and energy. That's why there's more chicken-based protein in Iams than the leading dry dog food. So feed your dog the taste he loves, Iams, and he'll thank you in so many ways. Because quality protein matters, insist on Iams.
Season sunrooms add light, drama, and value to your most cherished possession, your home. Our sunrooms come in a variety of styles and designs made to fit any home and budget, all built with the most advanced glass technology available. lifestyle with a quality four-season sunroom, solarium, or patio room. Call our toll-free number today for additional information.
Hurry into your participating four-season sunroom showroom today and take advantage of our Fall Savings Spectacular, held over for a limited time only.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Programming is brought to your home through a partnership with your local cable company. When you pay your cable bill each month, you help support our programming. Thank you.
And now it's time for the Michelin Drivers Report, brought to you by Michelin and your participating Michelin dealers.
We have continuation of rainy travel in the eastern United States. Particularly problems have arisen from New York on back down in the mountains of North Carolina, where the rain has generally been light to moderate, but sometimes heavier. So driving on 79 or 85 or 81 or 20 or 95, you could run into some problems with either low visibilities or water on the roads, ponding on the roads. Maybe even with some of the heaviest rain, you'll find run into some urban or lowland flooding. So drive with great care, if you will. There's the overall pattern in the east. Now, there's also rain in the west on the Washington-Oregon coast down into Northern California. And there's also some snow in those mountains. I'll show you that in a minute. But first, let's turn around and take a look at the possibility of strong thunderstorms from about Norfolk, Virginia, back down into the Big Bend of Florida. Wintery travel? Well, I'll have to turn around again, you see. In the Cascades at the moment is the biggest problem, and to the east of them where icing conditions have remained quite a problem. Look for strong winds through the middle of the country.
For regional Michelin Drivers Reports, call 1-900-WEATHER for 95 cents a minute and connect.
Snow. You've got Michelin's new all-season MXV4, a luxury performance tire with a very special feature. Climate control. Michelin. Because so much is riding on your tires.
Find Michelin tires at this dealer near you, because so much is riding on your tires.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
you're watching the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to for accurate, dependable weather forecasts 24 hours a day.
Time for our afternoon weather, which is sponsored by Wells Lamont. When the weather takes a turn for the worse, turn to the best, Wells Lamont gloves. As we check out the status on temperatures on this Thanksgiving weekend, it's been a cold turkey for a large area of the country. The northwest, the central plains, the northeast on Thanksgiving Day, and pretty much the same general area ahead on Friday. Now, Saturday, we found the record book still needing some more records, so we established some across the country, including Pocatello, Idaho at 12 below. Winnemucca, this marks the third day in a row that they had a record. 1 degree, pretty chilly. And this was widespread. Look at this, all the way into Texas and Louisiana. Waco and Shreveport, both at 20.